Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Today I'm going to demonstrate how to design custom 3D printable threads in Fusion 360. The method I'm going to show has worked very well for me every single time. While it may not be the easiest out there, this way you can literally produce an infinite variety of custom threads for your projects. For this tutorial, I'm going to design a small container with a screw-on lid. I'm starting off with a sketch on the front plane where I lay out the basic cross sections. I've sketched a total of 4 profiles. This profile is the cross section of the container's main body. The second profile defines the threaded section of the container. This other profile defines the cross section of the lid's main body. And this last profile represents the threaded part of the lid. Let's have another look at the sketch. Feel free to pause the video now and go over the constraints and dimensions. Of course, we can come back to this sketch and make changes at any point later. I can now create the bodies by revolving each of the 4 profiles I've just mentioned. Be sure to choose the new body option every time. Let's also rename them to not get confused later on. In addition, I add an offset plane that indicates the lower end of the threaded region. I continue by sketching the actual thread profiles in a new sketch, again on the front plane. I start off by projecting the relevant lines into a new sketch. At this point, I can basically design whatever shapes I want to use for the thread. While I'm sketching, feel free to like and subscribe, and if you have any feedback, questions or suggestions for future videos, please let me know in the comments. For simplicity, I designed pretty conventional trapezoidal profiles here. Note that the profiles are placed just below the offset plane, so this is below the region where the actual threads will be. I chose gaps of 0.3 mm throughout the design and an overhang angle of 55 degrees, which should be suitable for most 3D printed projects. I also included an ever so tiny overlap between the thread profiles and the solid part of the bodies. This is often essential to prevent inaccuracies in the later sweeping from messing up the final part. Also notice that within this sketch, I already have chosen a pitch value for this thread. This is the distance between one profile and the same profile after being rotated by one full revolution along the thread. In this case, the pitch is 4 mm. I don't use parameters in this video, so I'm going to just remember this value for the next step. Again, feel free to pause the video and have a closer look at the sketch. Now I create a coil. First, I sketch the base circle on the offset plane I've created earlier. Here I choose a diameter that is smaller than the actual thread. This allows for easier selection in the following steps. Then I choose the triangular external profile option and enter a section size of 1 mm. The actual value is unimportant, it just has to be smaller than the pitch. I choose the height and pitch option, enter the pitch value of 4 mm and choose a height value that is large enough so that the coil extends significantly beyond the thread region. Don't forget to choose the new body option again. Now we can finally create the actual threads. I start with the container. I create the sweep feature and choose the path and guide surface option. I select the thread profile from the sketch. As path, I choose the outer edge of the triangular coil. In this guide surface, I select the offset plane. Again, I want to create a new body. What is left to do is to combine the bodies appropriately. First, I intersect the body representing the threaded region of the container with the sweeping I've just created. In a second step, I combine the main body of the container with the thread. The container is finished now, and if I want, I can assign it a color. I repeat the same for the lid. I create the sweeping based on the same coil and same guide surface, but choosing the lid's thread profile. Then I intersect the thread region body with the sweeping before combining the result with the lid's main body and assigning a color. I don't need the coil anymore, so now I can remove it. If we want, we can put the bodies in different components now. I have now finished my model and we can do a quick check by looking at the bodies. The container looks fine. The lid seems to be perfect too. In the section view, we can see that the threads mesh perfectly just as intended. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Feel free to share your results. If you have any questions or suggestions, let me know in the comments. Have a great time designing and prototyping.